One of my favorite days is when we're doing Goat Head, and Nate comes in. He's like, "What y'all got for me today?" And it's just a table of cups. It's a table of cups and a 5-gallon bin. Is that was that the kick drum? It was like a bin or something.
Yeah, it was a bit. I think also it was a suitcase. Was it?
It was about a suitcase. Suitcase for the kick drum with a kick pedal, and then just a tray. It was like a triangle, a cowbell turned over on its side, and then like some cups. And we're like, "This is gonna be a drum set today."
We set him up like a French like movie.
But he rocked
a French silent film. You're like a drummer.
He rocked it though. He came in and played it. He played it like a drum set. It's crazy. And it sounds cool. Like this thing, it worked out. It sounds great. I'm always like going in there like maybe Sean went too far. But no, it sounds really good. And then like History Repeats is crazy because all the drums you hear, Nate Smith is doing live, right?
Yeah.
He's playing the big giant like concert bass drum, playing the whole beat, doing the cymbals, doing all that stuff.
I was obsessed with her demos because the first time I heard them, they blew my mind so much. And so I really wanted, when he was playing, I was obsessed with him playing all the stuff. Everything that was in her demo, I wanted him to be playing. So like if it was like a percussion overdub, I would set up a thing so like so that his part would have to be based on everything that she had done.
It was an orchestrated part.
Yeah, so it was like I'd set up a different element for everything that was in her demo. So it created these crazy drum kits, and I was like, "See, this part, this thing right here, that is dedicated to this thing in her demo. And this thing right here is dedicated to this thing in her demo." So when he was playing, he could build the part and have all these tones that were built already into her demo.
Getting all the room of this insane kit, and he did it in one second.
Yeah, and so he...
And he wouldn't do it again.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Because it was exhausting.
Yeah, it was super... Boom, boom. It was like, almost, like, I would think it was impossible for him to play it.
He kept saying it was impossible, and you kept telling him, just do it.
Yeah, you would say it was impossible, and then I'd be like, "You do it."
Yeah.
And then he'd go in there, and he would just do it one take, and it was that song on the record.
And this song, that's a lot of work. That's a lot of work.